Being able to look at the stars and seeing the vastness and us as this tiny speck, that is already in itself a huge paradigm shift for humans and a very radically not Earth-centered anymore.
In her studio in Brooklyn, mathematician-turned-artist Helena Kauppila paints her vision of what the sky would look like on another planet. The scientific discovery of thousands of exoplanets inspired her art.
We certainly don't know what it would be like to live on one of these exoplanets. And so that was also, to me, this artistic freedom, but also the role of the artist. We're kind of filling in a different kind of information, exploring a different kind of space than what science is exploring. This is the first one in this set, and I was sort of making it while making a lot of crap, really. I had this idea, I was struggling with a painting issue being the first color on the canvas was dominating everything that came afterwards. It was really affecting it a lot more than I anticipated, because I assumed oil paints are somehow opaque, but of course light is always coming, bouncing in from the very first layers.
The paintings may be abstract, but they are based on hard science. Kauppila uses real astronomical data to map the stars. She chooses distant exoplanets that astronomers have discovered in our universe.
The idea here was I'm incorporating an accurate star chart from a different perspective in the universe. These dots are actual star locations, bigger dots for brighter stars. This sort of abstract painting made by an artist potentially located in this different location in the universe. And this idea of them, both of these fields coexisting and having sort of a complementary purpose. So it's not illustrating the science, but sort of having these complementary types of knowledge that they're really searching for.
Kauppila uses online software to select and map her paintings. She picks a location in the universe and what direction she wants to look toward. The software prints an image of what the night sky would look like from that perspective. She gets a lot of her inspiration from the Kepler mission, which looks for exoplanets orbiting distant stars. The Kepler mission stared at a region of the sky for 4 years, watching more than 100,000 stars. It was looking for slight dimming in the light of the stars. When the light dims regularly, scientists can infer that there's a planet passing in front. So far, Kepler has found thousands of planets.
We don't have to see the star physically. We don't have to be at the planet to infer its existence. And this is somehow a power of science. On the other hand, there's so much unknown. More known than one would guess. But overall, there's so much unknown, and the idea that we don't really know what it would be like to be on this planet. And so on top of this hardcore science fact, I have full freedom as an artist